Hey, my name is Jimmy, and I am about to tell you how I made $75 million at the age of 13. This story all began when I was in science class, and we were studying the ancient ruins of Egypt. I got so intrigued that I spent all the money I made that summer on buying more equipment for my metal detector. The only problem was, I was in California. Even though I wasn't in the center of excavation heaven, I did come across a very old pickaxe about 3 months into my searching. After typing the number on the side into the computer, I found out that it was a naval pickaxe brought here by those that were searching for gold during the gold rush. My mom was terrified when I showed her the pickaxe I found, but my dad supported my hobby and told me to stay searching. That same day, I took the pickaxe to the nearest museum to see if they can display it for me so others can see my discovery. When the front desk saw the pickaxe, their eyes lit up and told me they were going to display it in the front room and put my name in big bold letters above it. I was so excited to have my discovery shown for everyone, but never ended up seeing the pickaxe again. I later found out that the pickaxe was worth $24,000, and a similar one was sold later that month for over $200,000. That made me angry. I was so excited to have my pickaxe displayed, and all they did was con me. Since the museum didn't display it, they probably sold it at an auction or black market. A couple months went by, and I didn't find anything worth my time. A bullet or belt buckle here and there, but that's about it. A couple days after the holidays, I was with my friend Logan, using the new metal detector I got as a gift, and it started going off like crazy. It was going off over an area of 10 square feet. Immediately, I told Logan to hand over the shovels, and we started digging. We dug in the same spot for almost 1 hour, until we heard a loud thump. We hit something big. It was some sort of metal object. I could feel it. We dug around it and finally had enough clear to see what it was. To my surprise, it was a minecart. But what was inside really caught my attention. A large chest that was made of metal and wood sitting at the bottom of this minecart. It looked old and rusty. I knew that the detector was going off because of the metal casing, but me and Logan chose to open the chest just to see what was inside. The whole chest was filled to the brim with gold nuggets. We got so excited and started jumping up and down. But when we went to lift the chest, it was way too heavy to carry home with us on our bikes. So I took one gold nugget, and we rolled the minecart back into the hole and covered it up. When I arrived at home, I ran into my dad and showed him the gold nugget. I told him that there are thousands where this came from. First thing he asked me was, "Does anyone else know?" I answered that Logan was with me. He immediately started up the truck, grabbed two shovels and a portable lift with lights. On our way to the minecart, we saw three flashlights walking around a mile or so from where the gold was buried. We decided to creep up to see who it was. To my surprise, it was Logan and his two older brothers. We overheard them talking about how they were going to take the chest for themselves before I could get to it. Luckily, they weren't as skillful in finding metals, because the number one rule is to mark where you found something on a map to find more in the area. I took out the map, and in less than 15 minutes we were at the spot. We quickly took out the portable lift and lifted the chest out of the minecart, loaded it onto the truck, and sped home. Turns out, all the gold together was worth over $75 million. This time, we knew to keep it to ourselves and not to go to the museum. We decided to sell half of it and melt the other half into gold bars that we now keep in a safe. What did we do with the money, you ask? We donated half of it to charity, and the other half? Well, let's just say I got to pursue my archaeology dream in Egypt for free. Just wanted to tell my tale. Thanks for listening.